So while we're on tires today,
are we on tires?
I mean, that's kind of what we're doing today, okay, at the time being. So when you first lowered your little truck and put the 20s on it, didn't know if that's what you were going to get.
They're a little taller.
Yeah, they're like a half inch taller.
I'm gonna like it, I think.
So
it needs to be a little taller.
When you first put the truck together and lowered it and everything, we just ordered some cheap junk tires off eBay, yeah, basically.
Yeah, they're like $50 a piece.
Yeah,
the junk.
Super cheap.
But driving this truck every day, yeah, look, that's what I'm gonna do every time. Especially, you know, if it's for Aiden or,
yeah,
you know what I mean? Something that we're gonna do a lot of burnouts in and fuck the tires up anyways.
Yeah.
But now that I know that I love this truck and I'm going to keep it,
yeah,
like I'm keeping this truck. I don't plan
on it. It's pretty sweet.
I love it. I love driving it every day, and everybody's always like, what are you going to do to it next? Man, nothing. I'm going to drive it. Like, if anything, that Audi in the bed right there.
No,
if anything, I'm going to put a blower on, a small blower on it, and still just drive it like it is.
This
like,
thing with
a
P1X.
I am not going to make a race truck out of this deal. I'm not going to do it because
it's too fun to drive.
I enjoy driving this thing. Anytime I have to go somewhere, I boom, you know.
Yeah, I mean, we cannonballed down to Texas Speed and picked up a motor with this thing.
That was stupid.
It was dumb.
That
we
was stupid.
We should have took the dually.
We should have took the dually.
But we did it, you know.
Yeah, no, we made it.
Yeah.
It's not necessarily made to haul shit.
No.
You know what I mean? But running around town, doing the little stuff that I got to do, love it.
Yep.
But the problem with these cheap tires that you buy.
Oh.
Is that, look, I've been gone for, well, we've been gone for 3 weeks.
Yeah.
I haven't drove this truck in 3 weeks. So it has sit here. So until you hit the highway and warm these tires up, there's flat spots in them. Just even from sitting for a couple of days.
Yes.
These cheap tires, I don't know what it is.
They're just
it's
junk.
The cheap tires.
My SS is the same way.
And they get flat spots in them really, really fast.
Yep.
Now, of course, you go hit the highway and in 10 miles or so, They're fine.
Yeah.
But you have to do that every time. And so if I just go from like from here to the convenience store, the thing's shaking and it's all over the place. And literally once the tires get warm, you can feel it go away.
Yep.
But it's a cheap tire. They have their place.
Mm-hmm.
But they don't have their place on a vehicle that I plan on keeping.
Nope. So,
man, I'll be honest with you. I was really impressed with the tires on the dually.
Oh, dude, they are smooth, smooth, smooth.
They are. The thing, I can't wait to get my other dually running once we get the motor back in that deal. And it's going to need tires pretty soon.
Yeah.
And as soon as it needs tires again, like, I'm not going to go buy tires for it as soon as we get the thing done, because that would be, in my opinion, a waste of money.
Well, and you're going to be broke because that thing's going to be expensive.
Yeah, I know. So I still have...
He didn't change.
He didn't change nothing. No, he didn't change clothes at all.
What'd you do for 15 minutes?
Bullshit.
Oh. All right, fair enough.
Ian's been at driver's ed all morning.
Yeah.
So, how did the driver's ed go? Did he have to hit the brake?
No, Greg's like, I trust you, so he put his feet up on the dash, because so it went boom, 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 and we were driving 70.
Uh-huh.
We were driving 70, and I was boom, 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 boom.
It was shaking?
Yeah.
He's in an OBS Tahoe. I liked it.
Yeah.
I think it's cool.
Yep, set that thing on the ground.
Yeah, no, the steering was pointed this way whenever it was straight.
That's right, it needs a little bit of work.
Yeah.
You know, it's like any other OBS.
Yeah.
AC probably.
I bet the AC didn't work that great. Probably had a little mist to it.
Was it warm? It did blow good.
Yeah.
Really? Hey, cold and blowing hard is two different things.
Yeah.
It wasn't blowing hard.
Yeah, not at all.
Yeah.
It's an OBS. OBSs don't blow hard. That's
yeah.
just part of it.
Yeah.
You got to give and take. You know.
Yeah.
Go help Dalton with those. I think that's all the tires. And then once y'all are done doing what Dalton's doing, throw those tires in the bed of your truck, and then we are gonna go and dispose of those tires.
I don't think these.
How come?
Man, this thing, it's got like some kind of lock type on
it. Is it spinning from the backside?
Yeah.
Okay, whatever we gotta do. I don't care if you cut it off. It's gotta come off.
Well,
otherwise, those tires will never hold air.
What? If you're 65, you're fine. But once you have to get 70, the whole dash shake, because the.
I'll bet if you did 85, though, the way that that thing's meant to do, it probably smooth right back out.
Well, the dash, I guess the Greek said he had the dash done, but the dude didn't put all the bolts back into it.
Oh, yeah.
Those are just spares.
Yeah.
Okay, so anyways, I'm kind of excited that the thing's gonna ride better. This is the only thing, Aaron's just about keeping everything stock. and about how I can't just leave something alone. So I get that.
Yeah.
That's fair enough.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Because I can't.
Decent point.
And the thing rides really good. And it seems like every time she's with me, I haven't drove the thing in a couple of days. So it's just, and she's just staring at me.
Like I told you.
I ruined the whole truck, you know? So I'm really ready for this thing to ride smooth again.
So we called our buddies over at Nitto. We used to run the 420S on everything.
On everything.
I mean, literally everything.
Like my brother still has the 420s on his Trailblazer SS.
Uh-huh.
And he called me the other day. He's like, hey, man, it's about time I get some new tires. I was like, hell yeah, you should get some.
Yeah, here, try these.
Yeah. What do you want me to do about it?
So we got the new 420V. It's a little...
Ryan at RK.
We got a little bit taller tire than what's on the truck, like a half inch taller. And we're about to slap these deals on. So once Sean gets off the phone here, we'll start pulling wheels, dismount, mount, go cruise this thing around.
No, I know. Here, where's the
knife? I don't think I'm not gonna work today.
Yeah, right on. So. I don't blame you. You got people for that.
Look, I got two guys sitting right over there. They look like some tire throwing fools.
That ain't no lie.
So
got them nice young backs.
That's right. So I think we're gonna get this thing up. Man, I like this truck.
It's pretty cool.
Okay, so we're gonna get this thing up, and then they're gonna come over here and pull these tires off.
Perfect.
And then I think we might see if Dalton can pull one of these deals off.
Oh, okay. I bet he can.
I bet he can.
I mean, these tires are litty, but
they're not that bad.
No, they're not bad. Well, they ain't no 275, 25, 26.
Nope. No.
So. Man, so seeing this tire around this wheel, I almost feel like the rim, the actual rim, not the wheel, the rim part of it needs to be black. Man, look at it through the camera.
I see what you're saying. I see what you're saying. It would focus more on the what I like about it, the five.
The spoke, yeah. You know, something to think about down the road. It's all right. We'll wait for them to get done playing around over here. And,
yeah, I've never seen anybody do that.
Uh-uh.
You could actually powder coat it like that.
Yeah, I know. Like just looking at it through this, man, that looks pretty good.
Almost looks like the 055 wheels.
Yeah, the champions, wasn't it?
No,
or
the five.
Oh, the comp five.
Comp five.
Yeah.
So, anyways, yeah, no, this is Nitto's new tire. So,
the 420V.
Yeah,
I've read some good stuff about them. I actually got a set for my truck too. Can't wait to get them on.
Yeah, we got to put a set on your truck.
Saying
you
no
actually
time.
Drive yours a lot.
I drive mine a lot.
It's weird that this is it's got the DOT number and that this is the right here, but this is the outside.
Oh yeah, huh.
265, 45, 20. And what's on it?
255.
255, 45, 20.
Yeah.
Yeah, these are a little bit wider too.
Yep.
A little taller, a little wider.
I bet it looks pretty good once we
I
get them on.
I think it's gonna look killer. Look how dirty this truck is, dude.
Yeah.
I've never washed it.
All of our shit is dirty right now.
Well, literally, we've been home for 2 days, guys, and we gotta leave in 2 days.
Yeah. You haven't even really been home.
No.
Like, you went up to New Mexico
and
picked up the Ace.
Yeah, the Ace, and then messed with the van up there.
So, and then I didn't do shit this weekend besides make a video. Like, I literally didn't do anything. Oh, I mowed my yard. It was a mess.
You should have filmed that.
Yeah. Huh? I don't know. Is it? Is that it? I don't know. Hit the
fart over here?
Not me.
I mean, farted over here, and I just
doesn't look like that's it.
It wasn't me.
Which one of y'all was it? It was Aiden here.
It was not me.
Dalton, where's the core remover? He's talking about this. No, I'm talking about the black core remover.
The little screwdriver looking deal.
Oh, okay.
Fair enough.
Yeah, I mean, hey, can't wrong with somebody for putting things where some things go.
Right.
it a little bit. Oh, you got some moisture in it.
I like it. Huh? So we'll have to check it on the Mustang alignment after we're done.
Get them balanced.
I mean, I get we got a balance machine right there, but I don't trust myself.
I don't either. Or myself. Mm-hmm. Remember when I tried to balance Aaron's Bronco tires?
But man, they weren't that bad. But why don't more air come out of this deal?
The damn tire pressure sensor's in the way.
I'm thinking just do it.
Ugh. Yeah.
That's a high call anyways. I owe you.
Get that stem out. We'll start letting air out of it.
Yeah, that's why I gave it to you.
Yeah. Yeah. Achilles. Junk.
They did their job.
They got you going.
Yep.
Just gonna make that Nitto feel that much better.
Stand up, look at us.
Yeah.
Because
you guys hear that?
He wanted some recognition, yeah. You know, because he just got the air out of that deal. Oh! Did I break it?
Oh yeah.
Man, that's exactly why I put it right there, so I wouldn't break it. Fuck. That sucks. Man, you know how many of them things I broke?
A bunch. Here you go.
You want to
see if you can glue it back together?
That's 100%. If that deal still works, that's asking a lot of it. Man, you know, hey.
Well, we got some Gorilla Glue over there.
Okay, this is the driver's side front.
Oh, that's the inside.
It says inside?
Yeah, right here.
Okay. So that goes this way.
Yeah. Oh yeah, that'll work. Something to slick her up.
Ooh, it smells good too.
Uh-huh.
Is that the part that everybody says you guys work too hard?
Yeah. Got that machine with all those attachments and you're doing all that manual labor.
Yeah, hey, I get it.
Look, we didn't use traction control either.
Hey, we're manual type dudes.
So these tires just like, they just fit the wheel better and everything.
Yes. And the first one gave us a little bit of trouble, but these two have went on.
Yeah.
You know, like it's supposed to.
Yeah. No big deal.
Over here trying to show these guys how to do it. They're probably looking at each other behind my back going, uh-huh. Hey, you don't know what the hell he's doing.
Yeah.
They ain't wrong.
You learning anything? Nah, me neither.
Look guys, this is how not to do it.
Yeah.
Good job, baby.
Nice job.
Oh, it's not out yet?
Yeah.
You took it out, didn't you?
Oh. Yeah.
Cue the compressor.
Seems like I always break one tire sensor.
Oh yeah.
Every time
it's always the first one.
It's always the first one, and then after that I go, Oh yeah. I forgot. But I still got the chance to break the last one.
Oh yeah. You can go 2 for 4
still.
I mean,
not that I can't break them all.
Yeah. You did break them all on something, wasn't it? Wasn't it the Trailblazer or the Cadillac?
No.
Like every one of them.
Every one. It was the Mini.
Yeah.
It was the fucking Mini.
It was the Mini.
Hey, you know, fucking with that like 12-inch wheel, whatever yep. that deal was.
Yep.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm pretty sure I went 4 for 4 on that one.
Anything we're doing right.
That's right. 4 for 4. Man, it's been one weekend up at Angel Fire, and look at me sweating. I'm in an air-conditioned shop.
Oh, yeah. It was nice and cool up there, huh?
Dude, it was cold. I had a hoodie on.
Really?
Yeah. And it was, 48 degrees whenever I got in the hot tub.
Damn.
It was nice.
It ain't gonna be 48 here for another 6 months.
No, that's why I ain't getting in the hot tub.
Yeah. Hold that and we won't be here.
Yeah.
Last one.
Inside. Dog got that under control over there?
Yeah, I was talking to him about plans that we got.
Sure you was.
You plan, what kind of plans y'all got?
What's the first one that we're going to?
Huh?
On Wednesday. Where y'all going on Wednesday?
Y'all?
No.
You're riding with family. In St. Louis.
Dad. What was it at?
Illinois.
So, when does the race actually start?
Friday,
like the rest of them.
Dalton gets his license on Thursday, right?
Uh-huh. You think he's gonna drive up there?
No. That's why he can't go with us this Wednesday. So I was thinking was,
okay, before you get too into this deal, Pawpaw's not coming to this one because there's no flights to where we're going.
There's no flights at all.
No flights. 2 hours, 2 hours.
These next two races are out in the middle of nowhere.
They're out in the middle of nowhere, and it's 2 hours to the nearest place that you can fly in. But I'm more than happy to fly him into, Virginia? What's the last one we're going to on this leg?
South Carolina.
I'll fly him in there. Papa's flying into that one.
Not if Papa's going. No, whatever.
You just don't want to fly alone?
No, yeah, I just
never flown before.
Ever?
Ever.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, no, he's never been on a plane.
I mean, hell, I guess I hadn't either till I was like 26 or 27. Yeah, the first time I ever...
He's flown more times than anybody can count. He thinks he's so deprived. You don't ever get to do nothing.
Yeah, no, I didn't.
Angus did a lot, didn't he?
I'm still never in South Africa.
Oh, that's
yeah.
That's where we're at with it.
Yeah.
You haven't been nowhere if you haven't been to South Africa.
Yeah.
I've been to South Africa.
I have too.
I know y'all love me, Winana.
Give me the cord.
Goddamn boy.
Where's all the hair and shit coming from?
No, it's on the left. No one's paying that dude.
No one.
Guess what you get to do today.
Now that you mention it,
it does need to be clean.
Better look real clean now, huh?
Yeah. How much slower that is?
Yeah. Yep.
So I messed the first one up, guys, just to let y'all know. Should really air this up before you put the valve core in it. Hear how much slower it goes right now? That's the reason that one wouldn't seal. Yeah. Look, my bad.
Yeah. It makes mistakes.
Even guys like me fuck up every once in a while.
Yeah.
Just gotta own that shit.
Yeah.
Aiden, go put this on.
Yeah,
you were, not because you told me to, because yeah. I was going to anyways.
You know, I'm going to my room because I want to.
Uh-huh.
No fire donk, it's real big in here.
Yeah, it is. Need to get it out of here. Who want to come by this deal?
Yeah. Thing runs like a top.
With that?
No idea.
Nope. Just clueless. Doesn't know what's going on. The reason he's wearing them badass shorts out here is because he knows he ain't gonna get them dirty.
Man, them do look a lot better.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, I'll bet my speedometer's a little closer down too.
Oh yeah, it was like 10 off, wasn't it?
It was like 7 off.
Yeah. Hey, you know what's cool?
Unless you was doing 100.
Yeah.
And then it was probably 10 off.
Hey, so you know what's cool about this lift? It goes up and down.
Yeah.
If that's to where it's not comfortable, make it comfortable.
Well, Dalton's done 3 on this height.
Oh, hey, put it on.
So I'm just, Bam's talking to me.
I don't care. Work while you talk.
Can't do that.
Maybe you should just quit working.
Now you're not, now you're gonna get a shirt.
Down?
Oh yeah.
What do you mean by sitting down? That's how you do it.
Yeah, eye level. Except you don't sit down.
Yep.
Not with a lift.
It's on there.
Yeah, I know it's on there.
Good job.
I'm glad to do this. Dalton did it 3 times.
Yeah, that looks pretty good.
It'll look real good here in a minute.
Yeah.
We still need some shocks for the rear of this thing.
Oh, has it still got those ones or whatever?
It still bounces around, yeah. Yeah.
Why is it so many spider webs in here?
I don't know what happened.
Well, he's gone for a couple weeks. I figured they'd move in.
Yep. They already took over out in the jungle outside.
Ugh.
And they're getting cleaned up out there.
Yeah.
Though.
What's up?
Is it stuck? Hey, those lug nuts do suck though.
They do.
Like, look, that's not. I understand that we like to laugh at you guys whenever you guys don't know stuff, but we've been doing this for years and we know. But those lug nuts do suck.
Yeah.
Even if I was doing that, they'd get stuck on there. It's just part of it.
God
dang, this scary, stupid thing.
You feel like your life is over.
Yeah. I'm at least going to get past that.
Yeah. That ain't happening when we move to the new shop.
No.
That ain't going to be there.
Somebody got to have a hole to fill in here, though.
Yeah.
Oh God.
Probably not ever getting nothing on that one again.
It was the lock. It's good.
Yeah, it's fine.
He goes,
hey, put that lock back in the center console because I'm obviously going to take this Mustang lime and have them balance them.
Did you have the other Valston covers?
The cap?
Yeah, the cap.
Oh, I don't know.
You gave me that
one. Hey. Let it down. Let's look at it.
Yep.
I bet you start it, it'll still lower. So start it. Turn the wheel a couple of times.
Yep.
I bet the fan comes down a little bit. Looks good. I like it a lot better.
Did you want me to do that?
Fills everything out a little bit more.
Yes.
What?
Did you want me
to start it. Turn the wheel. Let's see if it goes down. We'll just watch it straight from there. Yeah, maybe a little bit.
Yeah. I'm sure it'll settle some.
Yep. It goes okay.
Down the road. Much better.
Yeah, no, it looks a lot better.
And it's just a better tire. Like, you don't have to worry about all the dumb stuff.
I know.
You can just come home and drive this thing whenever you want.
I'm gonna take it down the road and see how bad it is.
Yeah.
See if it how bad. I mean, I've thrown some on before. It was fine.
Yeah.
Let's go down the road.
His truck, it's been to look good. Real cool.
Yeah,
we
so
got
if
some
we
stuff.
We put that lowering kit on that.
We got some stuff from McGoy.
But man, look at like this. We nailed it on that truck
for sure.
Like it's
it looks like a totally different truck,
and it needed to.
Yeah. Yeah. We just need to fix his interior up a little bit now.
The brakes are so much better than this than the dually.
Oh yeah.
Like you move these this far and you're going through the windshield. That's just lug nuts falling
yeah,
off.
Yeah, no big deal. I mean, up to 50, it's pretty smooth. This road kind of sucks too, though.
Yeah. And that tire pressure sensor definitely didn't work. But we know that it's this front wheel.
Yeah. Yep, ain't no guessing.
Hey, right now, without them being balanced, they drive better than what the other ones did.
Yep. Nice job, Nitto.
But I do have to admit, changing tires is one of my least favorite things ever.
Yeah.
If that is on our list to do,
Are you sure?
Yeah. Yeah, no, it actually rides really good.
Yeah.
Let's get on a decent road. Let's check the old mile per hour gauge too.
Oh, it's way closer then.
Yeah, it's way closer. Let me see. Uh-huh. 65. Oh, man, we're close.
Yeah.
66, 63.
Fixed.
And, dude, it don't ride that bad. You can tell a little bit, but
yeah.
It ain't bad. It ain't one of them things that I can't drive the truck until I get them balanced.
Yes.
We didn't even take anything off.
No, it's still got the weights from the shared tires.
Yes. Like throwing them off worse.
Yeah.
So, what sucks is, why am my cruise not working? See how it's white? That means it won't work. If the tire pressure sensor is off, does it not work?
Is that what it is? Can't remember if that affects it. Obviously it does, right?
But normally,
it'll go green.
It's just green.
Damn,
it's only green when it's on, though. I don't know. I'll try it whenever we turn it.
Oh, okay. You just turned it off.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, yeah, when you set it, it'll turn green, right?
We'll see.
Hopefully.
It's so irritating driving the dually.
I didn't get a brake switch today.
As soon as I get the fucking cruise to work,
then you gotta hit the brakes.
And then somebody pulls out in front of me,
yep.
And you gotta hit the brakes.
Yep.
Man, it pissed. I was downshifting it and shit, trying not to hit the brakes.
Yep.
It doesn't ever work though. There's a cop right there. I guess I can't bend this corner and stick it. Oh, how smooth that is, dude.
Mm-hmm.
Like Aaron's gonna like it that much better now.
Forgetting that it's Monday, it shouldn't be a holiday.
Yeah. But it is.
It's a holiday.
You know?
It was yesterday.
Oh yeah, no, it works.
Yep, good.
Hmm. until we decide to put a stereo in it, I probably won't do anything else. Because remember, we weren't going to put a stereo in it.
Right.
Because we were going to make it, you know.
Yeah, try to lighten it up, yeah, pull everything out we could.
We were going to replace the man van with this. But we're not going to. I don't have to have a truck. I do need a race daily driver.
Luckily, you have a 55 Chevy for that.
Well, that, which it has a cage. Hopefully, that's just my small tire car.
Mm-hmm.
But hopefully, the donk becomes the...
You're talking about the race donk or the...
Yes,
okay.
Race donk. That's not really a daily, though. It could be.
Yeah.
Like, real simple. It ain't really nothing right now because we haven't started.
No. It's a shell. Sort of.
Riding dirty.
Way up there.
You can tell how far he's up there?
Mm-hmm.
This is by how close?
Mm-hmm.
If it's up here, it's closer?
Mm-hmm.
Huh. I didn't even know that.
A lot of people ask what radar detector we use. It's a Valentine one. This is actually their newest version of it.
Yeah.
All the others we have are the V1, and they both work excellent, so.
Yeah, we like them.
Them 20, they're 24s, aren't they?
Them 24s, yeah. They keep them clean, though.
They keep them real clean.
I told him last night that he was driving Aaron's new truck home.
Yeah.
And I was like, don't hit no curbs. Why not? She hits them in my truck.
Oh.
And I was, oh, yeah.
We'll try to see what happens.
Yeah, yeah. It ain't gonna do nothing but hit her tire anyways.
Yeah.
More truck things.
Yeah, so we have
this
really,
is a nice rig here.
We haven't really shown anything about Aaron's truck ever. Okay, so we just picked this up for Aaron. Well, I say just, what, like a month ago? We've been gone for 2 weeks.
Yeah. So like a month and a half ago, whenever I went up to Boston. Austin, Massachusetts.
Yes, yes, for unknown reasons.
Yeah, whatever, you know. I wanted some clam chowder, man.
Yeah. Hey. So, Aaron had been driving Aiden's truck around so much. Just curb checking the shit out of the wheels. So, she started realizing what we love about Chevy trucks.
The greatest.
She's had, I bought her a brand new Denali before. Two of them.
Escalade.
Two brand new. The Escalade wasn't brand new, but yes, she had an Escalade. It's no different than these Chevy trucks, you know? So she realized real quick that she loved throwing the empty boxes, and she throws all the stuff that she goes to the...
whenever she ships stuff, when she ships all the merch. Out,
she goes to the post office like 3 days a week,
yeah,
shipping stuff off. And she'd fill up the bed of Aiden's truck and go ship it off. Well, she realized real quick that the truck thing is cool.
Mm-hmm.
So especially when you got to use one for work.
Yeah.
And so she was like, okay, I changed my mind. I just want a truck, except we need something with four doors. Because the problem was, is we kept on going to all of Aiden's baseball games. Well, I like to drive my little truck.
Mm-hmm.
And that's all good until we pick up Aiden and drive home. He ain't sitting on her lap, you know?
And I ain't got no middle seat.
Ain't got no middle seat. I didn't put the full console in that bitch. You know why? Because that's my truck.
Yep.
So... You know, and hopefully before too long, Aiden be 16. You know, another 8 months or so, he'll be 16. He'll be able to drive himself. We won't have that problem anymore.
Yeah.
But until now, you know, she needs something that she can run around in. She loves her K5. She's never going to get rid of that one. But the top is off of it for her to drive around right now. Well, so she wanted a truck, something with four doors, and so as soon as she said that, my eyes kind of lit up, and I got to get her something that I've wanted forever.
So yeah.
That's how this deal works.
It worked out.
So I told her, I was like, the Denali trucks are all-wheel drive. We can find an older one that has the 6.2 in it with which transmission?
It's got the 6L80 or 6L90. It's a 6-speed automatic.
It's a 6-speed automatic all-wheel drive Denali truck.
They're amazing.
And whenever we found this one, man, we got lucky. Which I wouldn't say we got lucky. We paid for what we got.
Dude, you can't find them. I've been looking because I, you know, I kind of want one myself.
Yeah,
they're awesome. They're hard to find.
They are hard to find. So we found her the 2011 Denali. It had 90,000 miles on it, and it is one of the cleanest trucks I've ever seen in my life. So you can look and see.
Probably full of dog hair.
That literally nobody's ever been in the back seat.
No.
Until the first day we got it home and she put her dogs in the back seat. So, and I tried to explain to her, look, you can lift these back seats up and then the dogs can run around back there and they're not gonna hurt nothing.
Yeah.
But instead, those dogs were just all over the leather, you know, just crawling around back there. But this thing is so new that here is all the stuff for the DVD player that's never been opened.
The headphones have literally never been
opened. And the remote still don't even have batteries in it. Oh, there's the brand new batteries.
Ain't nobody's ear sweat been in those headphones yet.
Look at the batteries.
Oh, yeah.
Wow. I'm guessing those aren't any good anymore.
No, they are corroded.
But just brand new. And when we say that this thing's brand new, this is how brand new it is. So everything in it is like new. Look, ain't got way too many pairs of these glasses if he just leaves them around everywhere. Hey!
Yeah.
Look! He's tweeting over there. He's tweeting over there.
Gross.
Yeah, well. So, it's literally never had anything in the bed.
Like the paint's only scratched off because of the rubber that rubs over it.
So, literally brand new. We haven't cleaned the thing up or anything. If anything, we've made it worse.
Yeah.
So,
it got a real altitude problem though.
Yes, it does. And Aaron being Aaron, she does not want to lower it because in her opinion, in her eyes, that's how we ruin everything. That is the start to ruining everything. Yep. You know, and whatever. She's not wrong.
No.
You know?
She ain't totally right, though.
She ain't totally right. No, because, you know, bagged vehicles ride every bit as good as, probably better.
Better.
So anyways, she does want it leveled. The back is way higher than the front, and that's just the way they come stock. So I'm pretty sure that we can lower the back 2 inches, and she'll never even notice it except for the looks. So I wanted to see what we are here, and we are... What, let's just call that 38 and 3/4.
Yep.
38 and 3/4. And the front here is 36 and 3/4 ish.
So 2 inches ought to be just right.
2 inches in the back will do everything that we want to do on this deal. And then she can leave her big tires on it, her stock wheels, which I'm totally fine leaving the stock wheels on it. Well, in all reality, I would get some 22s that look like those.
Some 22 replicas,
some
just like those.
Some 22 replicas is what I would put on this deal. And you never know, one of these days I may be able to talk her into it. Other than that, literally this truck is flawless. Oh, except one part. There's one dent in this truck. Look how dirty it is. And that is right here. And it's really weird what that is.
Damn.
Yeah, looked like somebody hit it with a claw hammer.
Yeah, that's exactly what it looks like.
I don't even know if a PDR guy could get that real close.
Yeah.
But since it's...
kind of got a little crease in it.
Yes. You know. I don't know. I'm sure that a PDR guy would get it a lot closer than what it is.
We need a good PDR guy, by the way, if anyone's local and watching.
We do. Okay, so we called our guys. Let me help me out here, Phantom. McGoy's.
Nailed it.
Okay. So our buddies over at McGoy's, we told them what we were doing here, and they was like, yeah, no problem. You know, it's just a shackle.
Yeah.
A shackle in the back of this deal will lower it to 2 inches that we need, and it doesn't change anything. Maybe the pinion angle a little bit.
Yeah, but at 2 inches, that don't even matter.
Eh, it ain't gonna hurt it.
Yeah.
You know? Especially the way that we're going. Okay, so...
What you eating?
You guys good?
We're ready.
You guys still on break or?
So we did call my boys and we ordered everything for Aiden's truck too.
Yes.
So
it needs to come down.
We have Aiden's truck needs to come down. It's pretty amazing, but it does need to be lowered a little bit more.
Yeah.
and the C-notches. We bought them out two or three times on the way down there.
That thing C-notched?
No.
Oh. I was going to say.
The thing, it will become C-notched.
Yeah.
So I'm guessing that this is probably the shackles, if I had to guess.
I bet you're probably right.
It is. Okay. Stop. Read this first.
Stow that away.
Rear shackle instruction. I mean, exactly what I thought they would look like.
Yep. Yes, this is a shackle.
Piece of cake. And we definitely going to go to this hole. So.
Oh, yeah. As low as possible.
Yes. Well, we say that. Remember I had to cut mine off on my little truck and raise it back up?
Yeah.
It was too low.
Yeah.
But
that was flipped and.
Yes. This one, literally nothing else except this right here.
Yeah.
So we're going to get it up. We're going to pull the old ones off. We're going to put these new ones on. Guys. Y'all ready to do this?
Get your ass over here.
Okay. So, Aiden's truck stuff from you know, the whole McGoy's kit here, and it is what, 4.6?
It's 4.6 or 4.7 is what it will be. I think we have the choice between 6 and 7.
Okay. Well, we'll figure that out. Depends on the C-notch. We definitely don't want it to hit. And we also don't want him ripping the front bumper and shit off.
No.
He's still, at this point, a 15-year-old kid, and it doesn't need to be that low.
Look, dog, I'm 36, and I've ripped mine off twice in the last week.
Yeah, you did. Yeah, so there's just no hope. Just no hope.
It looked real ugly without that thing, too.
It does. Go over there, guys. Raise it up. It's already on the lift. Just hit it. Raise it up. And, Aiden, we are going to need both of those.
You listening?
Yeah, no, I'm trying.
Yeah.
Trying what?
Trying to listen.
Oh, you're trying
to tell me about your Gardettos.
Yeah. He's like, Dalton's over here
already
working.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, these things are good, guys.
Black button. No.
There, that's it. This thing falls off the lift. Aaron's gonna kill us, guys.
Remember that one time?
Yes. I wish we'd have got that on camera.
Man, it's gotta be on a security camera.
It's gotta be. So one time, guys, Phantom comes up and gets me, and he's sweating and shit. And he's like, come here. I need your help. And he's just fucking. Is this story time? What are you doing?
What else to do? It's getting
ready. I don't care what. I told you. Look, we need both of those. Go get them out. Man. So you come and get me, and you're like, hey, man. I'm in a bind. I need you.
I'm in a tight spot.
I'm in a tight spot. So now I'm still going to hit my head right there. Go up. And so I come down here and the truck literally fell off the lift and is hanging like this. And I went, damn.
Total amazement.
Because, hey, it's this close to just the shit you see on the internet.
Yes.
The memes.
It was about to be a meme.
And so I reached up, it was over here.
Yeah, I had it backed in.
The truck was backed in, this is the front. I reached up, I grabbed this wheel, and I pulled it, and the whole ass end of the truck came up. And so it was teeter-tottering on it like that. So, man, we worked it all out, but damn.
It's when I was for a lady swapping my SS.
It wasn't that long ago.
No, this is recent, very recent. Like, I wasn't feeling good and shit. Like, it was time for me to go home.
After that, you went home.
Yes, it was time for me to go home, and yeah, My truck fell off the lift. It was pretty sweet. I think you have a picture of it, right?
Probably so.
Yeah.
He's 6'4".
Okay, so man, look at everything over here. Stop. That'll work. No, that'll work. We're good.
It's back here.
So everything under, look how nice it is under here. Oh, shock's got a little bit of rust on them, don't they?
So, you did kind of break your rule when you bought this truck.
I did. I do have a rule that I do not buy anything from... Look. And this is why.
Yeah.
This is why I don't.
Yep.
So, even these wheels are starting to...
Oh, my God.
Yeah. That's all the chrome coming off. And this is why I have that rule. But this truck was an exception to the rule.
Yeah.
Like, there's no rust under here. So, you can tell, though, on that this thing... didn't get driven much in the snow.
Yeah. I mean, for the most part, it still got the undercoating on it.
Yes, like, it does. But think about a truck like this that has 300,000 miles, what it would look like.
Oh, dude.
That would be my rule. Yeah. That's why I have my rule. I will not buy cars from the Northeast.
Yeah.
And in my opinion, this is as close to the Northeast as you can go.
Like, I mean, it's, Indy is Indy, in the Rust Belt.
Indy is Northeast to me.
Yeah.
So I have that rule for a reason. And if this truck wouldn't have been so clean, we crawled all underneath it. We looked.
Oh, yeah.
No sign. I mean, I know you can't see that right there, but filling all inside here, it is just perfect. Yeah. Like, and the stuff that normally rusts on these things, believe it or not, right above the bed,
yep,
and then the rockers underneath here,
yep,
are really bad. And this is just perfect. There's literally nothing. So even though you can start to see all this stuff.
Yeah, but we could hit that with some POR 15 or something, yeah, or anything,
but,
really.
But, you know, not driving it up there,
yes,
not living, yes, up there, we'll handle the rest. Okay, those go in the back. Put those on the rear end, guys. But I did, whenever we were underneath there, I could see little stuff like this right here. Okay, see, you can see the coating is already starting to come off,
yeah,
of this. So, you know, but it was one of those deals. I rolled the dice. I took a chance. And I'm glad
I
did, because it is still so nice.
Yes, very nice.
But you can definitely tell, man, that a truck like this right here with 300,000 miles on it is going to be brutal.
Rust,
and that's the reason that they're rust.
Yeah. So if anyone has a lead on one of these, preferably in bright white, 2008 plus, holler at me.
2008 is the first year of the 6.2.
Yeah.
I want this.
I want the 6-speed, and it has a, it still has the same transmission.
Okay.
It got the 6-speed.
The first Denali I ever bought, Aaron, was an 08.
Yeah.
And then the second one I bought her was an 09.
Yeah.
And the 09 sucked. The 08 was cool.
Oh, yeah. That was the black one.
The black one was terrible.
Yeah.
The white one.
Yeah. Yeah. So if you find one, holler at me. I'm in the market. I ain't paying 20 grand for one, or I might if it's nice enough.
Shit, you probably aren't gonna find one then.
Yeah, that's what I say, if it's nice enough.
That one that was in Memphis that I was looking at was 19, and it had, what, 136,000,
yeah,
on it, something like,
yeah,
that, and it was really nice.
Yeah,
miles. It had the peanut butter guts like this one too.
Miles ain't really a thing to me. I don't really own anything with under 200,000 miles, no, besides my SS.
And it won't have 200 on it for long.
Yeah.
All right, guys.
So we're putting lowering shackles on this thing. We do this to most vehicles that we want to set just a little bit better, and we don't want to put a bunch of effort into getting it super low.
Put that up. Actually, here, go ahead. I'll go get
1316.
Yeah, 1316 on both sides.
Yeah. So, pretty simple task.
It is. It's not, the only thing that sucks is the way that they put the bolt in.
Oh.
That's the only thing that sucks. So basically, as soon as we get both of them off, we have to raise the whole rear end all the way up to the bed, and then that bolt will come out through between the bed and the frame.
Right.
And there's only this much room. So that's the only thing that sucks about changing these.
Other than that, really super simple. You can get your shackles just about anywhere, really. Oh, you didn't like my ratchet? It's kind of junk, huh?
Well, I'm gonna get this size with the 1316s. And then, I got this new stuff called electric.
Yeah.
You used to always try to get me to use,
yep,
back in the day, and I wouldn't ever use them because electric shit sucks. But now it's good.
Yep.
And now I look at people. Remember how I used to look at you using hand tools, and I'd laugh, and I go, "There's a whole air compressor right there," and I'd laugh. And now,
yep,
I look at people who use air, and I go, "You know."
So you can get your shackles just about anywhere. Most of the time, we end up with McGoy's.
You get them both off?
No, not yet.
So that's what we got for this rig.
Okay, so. Get light or something in here, huh? You gotta go in more, right there. And this is why my elbow hurts every morning.
It's got them stupid lock nuts. You wanna try mine?
Mine just sucks.
Oh.
Anymore. But yes, if yours looks better than mine. Okay, there you go, Dalton. Aiden, hold that side. Here, let me see that.
Is that yours?
Yep. You need to set it on there.
I still think that ratchets work better.
Oh, is it tightening?
Mine's week.
We need to send yours in.
There you go. Now go to the other side. Use this. Hey, use your arm. Is it warm?
Yeah.
So I do use electric tools a lot. Yes. If you guys don't have one of these, they're expensive, like, but they're worth the money.
Until that gets it off.
Okay. Snap-on 3/8 electric ratchet.
It's 100% worth it. We use, and trust me, guys, we don't get any kind of, we don't even get a break from Snap-on. We owe the Snap-on guy and pay him weekly like everybody else.
Yep.
Yeah, I got it on there.
Yeah.
No, it just keeps looking at me like I'm stupid. It just keeps falling off. Oh, look.
Hit that button, Pimpin. See if it'll come off.
It won't.
Nope, not yet.
Hey, there's only this much. You know why? Look. See, when there's only that much, you got to make sure that you hold it on there straight. If you get it a little bit off, then it's going to jump like that. Okay, here. Hey, there you go.
Shot.
He's holding it this far from the end, and there's this much.
He may as well be holding the head of the bowl with his finger.
He still don't really get the leverage deal, you know?
Dad.
But I see what you're doing. No, you're doing this.
No.
You gotta do it. You gotta hold it like that. There.
Use your strong arm.
He also doesn't know about putting it up against the frame right there and let it hold itself. Just like that.
Boom.
Now look, you can let go of this hand and just hold it on with this. Let go with this hand.
No.
Let go with this hand.
Yeah.
See there? See how that works? Okay, here. I'm done. I'm like...
Dad.
Does it work now? Dad.
Look, it's on. I haven't moved it from where you were holding it. It just starts jumping.
But it was working whenever I did it.
That's what I just said.
Crazy.
Reminds me of Chuck tells Chuck! That's what he does.
Man, dude, I wish I'd have had that conversation on video.
We got to get Chuck to tell you guys the story about
Swole.
Swole, whenever they crashed.
Driving the motorhome.
The motorhome. Anyways, we'll let them talk about
God
that.
Dang,
this
man.
It's one of the funniest stories I've ever heard Chuck tell.
We were at a pretty nice restaurant one night, and he's telling this story, and we're just laughing so loud. Yeah. I promise this is easy, guys.
It is. There's no doubt about it. And we've only got an hour to make this deal happen. So I gotta go. Got shit to do.
Yeah.
They're gonna make it happen, though.
Yeah.
Hardest part's coming here in a minute. Getting them bolts out. It's slipping off of there. Job.
Okay.
Now look, hey. No, you don't hammer them bolts out. You raise the rear end up until these bolts move. Look, they're almost moving on their own right now. Look at that.
How you get that?
Oh yeah, the hitch has to come out. I had to do that on my truck.
What?
I remember now. Yeah.
And thanks, Pat.
It does on this side too, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Ah.
Because remember I asked, hey, should I just cut this thing?
No, I know. Yeah, no, it should just be notched out.
Yeah.
I forgot about that. That does suck.
Damn it, Reese.
Yeah, just cut that deal.
No. Okay, get the big dog. Hey, it's just these 6 bolts. It ain't a big deal. And these two.
Yeah.
It's just these 6 bolts and these two. I'm gonna make it go. Nothing about this is... I mean, it's not like it's hard. It ain't a hard job. It's just this right here is almost like they didn't want nobody changing these deals out.
Yeah. Like they thought they did it right from the factory or something.
Yeah. Like they were cool with their trucks sitting like this. They obviously still are because this is 2011.
Yeah.
And they're just getting worse.
They just
worse.
Got worse, yeah. One of those deals, there are a few correct tools for the job, which basically a 21 millimeter socket will get most of everything done, but once you get to this point, you just make it happen.
Yes.
With whatever you got.
Okay, bring me the new ones, guys. I believe they're on that red card over there. So before, in your Duramax that you bought from me,
mm-hmm.
we just cut these right here off, and Lutz extended them for me.
Oh, really?
Yeah, because I ordered a couple, and those. Mine, since it was a 2500, was a little bit, they were the 2.5 instead of the 2. We couldn't find the right ones. And Lutz goes, I don't know what you're doing that for anyways. And he went, yeah, yeah. And then he welded it all back together. All right, let me see. Okay.
Now, we said you can get your cycles from just about anywhere, but I promise you the McGoys are nicer than something you'll get on eBay or Amazon or wherever you might buy your parts. Yeah.
I mean, that's pretty much where it's going to set right there.
Hello? Yes.
Okay. I don't need this anymore, I don't think. I might, though.
Oh, you're going to put it back in from that size, huh?
Man, if not, you got to cut the bolt off. I know every time I'm like, I ain't putting these back in there like this.
And then you try to put it the other way.
Yeah.
Oh, well, that's how they help.
It was a brand new bed, huh?
Yeah.
Raise them up. That ought to do it.
Roll them up.
Roll them up.
A little form.
Form. All right, guys, look, I'm sure that there's easier ways to do this, but this is the moron way, okay?
This is the way we're doing
the
it.
Way, this is the way we're doing it.
I would say the correct way, not necessarily the easiest way, would be to lift the bed, but...
Well, yeah.
Even at that point, when you set the bed back down, that shackle or the leaf spring is still going to hit the bed. So you may as well do it like we did it. Oh, it was a little warmer than you thought.
It's pretty warm on the fingers.
Put it down that dirty water.
Dirty water.
Because my hands are so clean. I'm about to put them in my mouth, I'm sure.
Cleaner than when you dump the shitter on the toter.
Uh-huh. And I put my fingers in my mouth after that, too. Yeah. So
started eating you some Nerds jellies or whatever they are.
Yeah.
That looks like a real pain in the ass.
I just don't understand. Am I going to have to pull this off? I know it would go if I could tap it.
There it is.
No big deal.
Fuck. Piece of cake, man.
Like we said, pretty simple task.
Like we said, no problem, guys. Yeah. All right, hey, let's, before this thing falls off the lift, let's lift it up just a little bit. Hang on. Don't get my fingers in here. All right, guys. Put them nuts on there. Hey, Aiden, lower these down real quick.
Those are for that.
Now just reverse the process.
Uh-huh. Piece of cake, like
no,
we said.
Yeah. Just like we had said, no big deal.
Like, even though it sucks, this is still hasn't been an hour.
No.
You know what I mean? So, it is what it is.
And
know?
It can be done but, on your back in your driveway.
Wait, hit me in the stomach. Yeah, it can be done. Like...
The lift makes it a lot easier.
I know that there's people right now going, well, I did that by myself in my driveway, you know, which, you know, you can.
Oh, yeah.
100%. Good job.
Yep. They're probably an ASC certified mechanic.
That's right. We're not.
No, just a couple of morons.
We don't know anything about mechanics.
No. A couple of morons and some kids that like cars.
That's right.
I guess not even close.
No, it's close.
Little.
That's good.
Little speed secret. I don't ever get those tied on shop truck.
No, I'd never do.
You want like, that loose they're, so they're
it'll supposed
move.
To, they're supposed to, they got to do their job.
Yeah.
But ideally, they shouldn't, even if you tighten them up, see how they got this metal in the middle?
Yeah.
It's not supposed to get that tight.
Right.
But you can still over
this.
Good. Okay, over here now. We passed a truck like yours going down the highway yesterday, same color. Had old four-wheeler jump. Looked like they just jumped it from wherever into the bed of the truck. It was kind of piled.
And dude, like an SS?
Oh yeah. Same color and everything. Huh. Every piece of cladding on that deal just shaking going down the highway.
Poor truck.
Yep. Perfect. 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 See that right there? It started bending in. That's when you know you're good. You don't really need to go that far. Okay. Let it down. Tell your mom come get her truck. Put these tools up. Yep. These are all his.
Dalton. This is a socket, right? Or is this fucking wood? Socket's mine.
Oh, that's cool.
Uh-huh.
That's it.
Yep.
That's all we'll get.
Yep.
Now watch. It doesn't matter what happens. If she feels something, it don't drive the same. You know.
What'd you guys do to my truck? Level.
Perfect. Oh, grab my flashlight underneath there.
Nailed it.
I mean, did exactly what we wanted it to do, didn't
it?
Yep. Huh? Tell me what you think.
Look at
the truck? Yeah.
You can't do anything, have you?
Yeah,
you don't. Burn, burn,
burn. It's lower in the back than what it was.
Hey, that thing's
you can't
level.
Tell it's level?
That thing's level now.
God damn. Here, take your truck.
Just get out of here.
2 inches.
No.
Look at the front, then look at the back. Look at the front, look at the back. It's the same.
Evil.
It wasn't the same before?
No, it wasn't.
Yeah.
No, it's good.
Uh-huh, okay. All right, take it.
At least we didn't mess that up.
Yeah.
Still runs.
Oh my God.
Man, it looks so much better.
Yes.
Start on it yet? Perfect. I love it whenever I'm telling somebody where to go and I still see them look in the rear view and in the mirrors. Just that's pretty much just saying, fuck your signals. Uh-huh. Not Aiden. Aiden, trust me when I tell him to do something. I told him last night while we was driving, I go, you're clear, he goes, brrr.
Yeah,
he
totally on his mirror.
Nothing. So Aaron,
yeah,
don't yell at him. Dude, no, okay, just park it wherever.
No,
that looks a lot better.
Yeah, no, I said, no, you're clear. No, I was talking about
hangover. Yeah.
So he just whipped her on over?
Yeah, he did.
So much better.
Yep.